Giselle. She poses a danger to both him and her child.
And now, the investigators were all but convinced that Giselle had posed a danger to Michelle, too.
The only question was there enough evidence to prove that she didn't?
They didn't have a body, but at Samuel Mary University, where Michelle had been finishing up her nursing degree, the investigators did uncover yet another important clue. When investigators interviewed employees at the university, a secretary told them she'd seen Giselle there the day before Michelle disappeared.
Giselle had gone to the campus.
The secretary told the investigators that she'd spoken to Giselle under what appeared to be innocent circumstances.
She went in there and pretended to be interested in joining the nursing program.
Giselle had named her a faculty member that she wanted to talk to. The secretary said, oh, she's not in right now. She'll be in at 9 o'clock. So you can come sit in my office until she gets there.
The secretary told the investigator she'd stepped out to do some errands.
When the secretary came back, Giselle said, oh, forget my appointment. I'll come back later. And she left.
And according to the secretary, shortly after that was when the college ID badge the investigators found in Michelle's car had turned up missing.
Giselle didn't get that so that she could snag a security badge.
Based on footage from the school's security camera, she had quickly put the stolen security key to use, too.
Later that evening, Giselle came back to the campus and used the electronic key card to gain access to the campus.
Went into the off-limits areas and started rummaging around.
And based on one thing, the security cameras revealed.
In her hand, she has a class roster.
The investigators had a pretty good idea of just what Giselle had been trying to find.
She had been trying to glean when Michelle was going to be at the hospital.
And if that wasn't enough proof for the prosecutors, the DNA results from the inside of Michelle's car were back from the crime lab by the beginning of September.
We found Giselle's DNA on the signal panel of Michelle's.
But the real clincher was the results for the shoes Giselle had put on before going to the police station.
We found blood that belonged to Michelle on the bottom of those sneakers.
It was time to make an arrest.
On September 7th,